He really spoke to me regarding Ryan's heart. And I heard God just audibly say that to me, do not hurt him. And it was just incredible. I was honestly blown away. What's up, guys? Melissa here, and honestly, I'm pretty shocked with the response I got in my first ever YouTube video where I document how God wrote Ryan and I's love story. We're getting married in February. It's going by so quickly, but I wanted to do a part two because I'm documenting what God is teaching me as He prepares me for marriage. So this video is going to be focused on how God gave me clear direction and guidance as I was dating Ryan, and how I knew he was the one. What does the one even mean? I'm going to really unpack that in this video as well and just teach you some things that I learned in regards to red flags I saw in other guys before meeting Ryan. And obviously, I want this to be an open discussion with you. I want to be honest and vulnerable, which is what all of my videos are focused on. So don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date on faith-based content. Like I always say, I am here to dive into God's word, ask hard questions, and see what He says about them. So don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date. And with that being said, grab your Bibles and let's get started with part two of how God wrote Ryan and I's love story. All right, let's start with this question. How do I know this person's the one? This is something that I wrestled with during my single years because we throw around that question, finding the one, who is the one for me? And ultimately, I don't think the one actually exists. There is no perfect match, no perfect soulmate for you. And this is something that God was teaching me as I was thinking about who I wanted to marry. At the end of the day, our ultimate fulfillment comes from God, and He gives us free will to choose commitment, to choose marriage, and to choose a person that you want to spend the rest of your life with and that you want to really grow in God with. And this was huge. I remember just really earnestly praying to God and asking for discernment in regards to my future husband because I wanted someone who was on fire for God. I dated here and there, but I never met a guy that was totally sold out for God, and this is something that I wanted. And so as I sought God in prayer, He was able to give me the guidance and direction I needed. Now, if you saw part one of this video, I documented how Ryan and I met and how God gave me a vision. But long story short, we met at church and God made us cross paths in an incredible way, which I really wasn't expecting. And it sounds cliche, but I think God does that for a reason, so that He becomes the author of our story instead of us taking control. And it was really cool to see our relationship unfold from the beginning. But I remember asking God, you know, I don't want to waste my time anymore. I don't want to date around. I want to know who my future husband is. And I really was honest with God regarding my heart's desire, regarding what I wanted in a future husband. And I really felt like God wanted me to be honest with myself, because I think if we're not honest with ourselves, we won't truly know where our hearts are at. And I remember the first few months of Ryan and I dating, I prayed so much and I was really, really hesitant, because when we first met, what really drew me towards Ryan was his relationship with God. We had really awesome conversations regarding theology and how he grew up and how he hears from God. And I was like, wow, there's something unique in him. But I still wasn't sure. I didn't want to be blindsided. I didn't want to commit to a guy who wasn't fully on fire for God, like I mentioned. I remember when he first asked me out, it was pretty funny because I wasn't expecting him to ask me out. But when he did, honestly, it took me 2 weeks to actually respond to him and go on a date with him because I was so hesitant. Because this time around, it was different. I told God, you know, is this from you? Is this someone I should even go on a date with? I was being extra, extra careful because I was tired of guys wasting my time. And so I really wanted to have clear discernment, but that's kind of where I was at. And obviously every person is going to have a different story. And yeah, this was just where my heart was at. Now, a few months before I met Ryan, I remember telling myself, okay, Like I said, I don't want to waste time. I want to find a guy who's totally sold out for God. And so I started to write out qualities and characteristics I was looking for in a guy. And I actually have this list, and I specifically remember writing, I want a guy who reminds me to read my Bible every day, who has such a personal relationship with God that I can see it in his actions, not in his words. I want someone who's humble enough to not brag about their relationship with God. They were very, very specific. God confirmed these very specific prayers that I had, especially the one regarding reading my Bible, because Ryan reads his Bible every single day and he always reminds me to read my Bible. And this is a prayer that I had. So as cheesy as it sounds, make sure you think about, okay, what do I want in a future spouse? It's so much more than physical characteristics. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about qualities that really show you, oh, this person actually loves the Lord and I can see myself with this person. This is what I really wanted and what I earnestly told God. And so, you know, it's so cool to see how God answered my prayer during that time. Now let's talk about red flags. Red flags are tricky because as a girl, you can easily ignore certain red flags, especially if you're in a relationship with someone that you really, really like because, I don't know, they have a cool hobby or great hair or whatever it may be, and you just ignore everything else. And so this is something I really want to caution you, because God's timing is perfect and noticing red flags can help you discern, okay, what do I want in a future spouse? And if this person is bringing me down, I need to step away and know that God's plan is bigger than anything I can come up with myself. This is something I've repeated so many times in so many videos because God continues to teach me this. And this is something that he taught me when he brought Ryan into my life. Before Ryan, I remember dating here and there and meeting guys that called themselves Christians, but they didn't really read their Bible, they didn't really pray, they didn't really have a personal relationship with God. And I remember instances where I started to get influenced in a negative way because of that. And I'm so thankful for my previous breakup, especially because it was so negative that walking away from that made me feel like, okay, you know, I want someone who loves the Lord and pushes me to love the Lord, and I want to grow with them, you know, because my personal relationship with God is so important to me, because God is everything, you know. God is the creator of the universe. He's the creator of our hearts and our souls, and he wants what's best for us better than we do. And so there are some questions I wrote down regarding red flags. And if you are dating someone that you're not sure about, I encourage you to ask these questions and be honest with yourself. The first question is this person drawing me away from God or drawing me closer to him? Is this person drawing me towards sin or protecting me from it? Is this person respecting my purity and my boundaries? Is this person's relationship with God so unique it intrigues me and pushes me in my relationship with God? Now, these questions are convicting because not only do you want to ask these questions when you think about who you want to marry, but you also want to ask these questions about yourself as well, because you don't want to be that person with red flags, right? And if marriage is something that's a desire in your heart, but at the same time is not something that you're idolizing, I believe that that is in God's plan for you. But you have to earnestly pray and make sure that your relationship with God is first priority. And I believe those single years are critical to growing in your faith in God, because we can be so focused on thinking about what we want in a future spouse, we forget about ourselves as well. So these are questions I asked myself and I was really careful with when I was dating Ryan, because I thought to myself, is this person all talk or does he have those actions that show me, oh wow, his relationship with God is incredible? And God continued to show me that he had a unique relationship with God, and it encouraged me and pushed me to draw near to God. But this is something that starts with ourselves, with our quiet time routine, and with just how we prioritize time in general. Romans 12:10 says, "Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourselves." And this verse is so beautiful because it reminds us how we are supposed to act. not only with the person that we're dating or the person that we're marrying, but in every area of our lives, with our neighbors, with that difficult person. How are we loving others the way Christ calls us to love others? And I believe this is critical because it really shows us where our hearts are at. And this is something that I've struggled with in the past as well, that I continue to struggle with. But God reminds me that marriage is not the ultimate fulfillment for me. And I need to make sure that I don't make life all about me, my needs, and my wants, because at the end of the day, nothing's going to satisfy me but God. As I prepare for marriage, seeking God's guidance is critical, and it was especially critical in my first few months of dating Ryan because, like I previously mentioned, I was very hesitant, I was very unsure because I wanted to think logically about everything. This is the first time I actually had to take a step back and say, if this is something from you, make it clear. If it's not, take it away from me. In the first few months of us dating, it was also hard for Ryan because he was never sure if I wanted to commit or not. But I was in a vulnerable stage in my life because I didn't want to get hurt. I wanted to be with someone that was actually ready for commitment. And Ryan did say he was ready for commitment, but in my head, I was like, I want to hear from God about this. And so I remember one night just earnestly praying to God, and I asked him specifics, which is the first time I've ever asked him specifics in regards to the person I was dating. And I asked God, what do you think of Ryan? Is this someone that you want me to commit to? And God spoke to me in very real ways. I encourage you to ask God those specifics because he is ready and willing to speak to us as we continue to grow in him and build our relationship with him. And so having that quiet time with God is so, so critical. And when I did that, the first thing God spoke to me was in regards to who Ryan is. He reminded me that he delights in Ryan. And this was so huge. I was honestly blown away at how specific God was just really speaking to me regarding Ryan. And the second thing he told me was, do not hurt Ryan. Because obviously I wasn't planning on hurting Ryan, but I was very hesitant. And I remember later on talking to Ryan about what God spoke to me. And I said, you know, God told me that he didn't want me to hurt you. And Ryan was like, wow, that's incredible and very reassuring because I thought that you were going to say no. I thought that you were going to say, I don't want to continue dating you. And from his point of view, he didn't want to get hurt. And so God really saw Ryan for who he was, and he really spoke to me regarding Ryan's heart. And I heard God just audibly say that to me, do not hurt him. And it was just incredible. I was honestly blown away. And it was really cool to see how as I sought God, he answered me in those very quiet moments. I have to continue to remind myself, like, wow, God is so good and he hears our prayers. And he wants to meet us right where we're at. So no matter what season you are in, show God your heart. Ask him specifics. And if you're dating someone that you're not sure about, ask God, what do you think about him? What do you think about our relationship? It's something that I am continuing to do as I prepare myself for marriage. What kind of wife does God call me to be? You know, how do I make sure that my marriage is not about myself? Because marriage is supposed to be a selfless act, not a selfish one. All right, so like I previously mentioned, Ryan and I are getting married in February. We are both so excited and it's going by so quickly, which is crazy, but we recently started premarital counseling. And our officiant is actually going to do our premarital counseling, which is awesome because we were struggling to find someone. But before we went to our first session, we had to take a test, and it was basically a compatibility test where we had to answer questions about our childhood, our emotional behavior, our wants, needs, expectations of each other, and I had to really think deeply about these questions. But once we got our results, which we got them when we went into counseling, and they basically talked to us about how we can work together and how we can understand each other better, which was very enlightening. But it showed me that marriage is about compromise. And I've always known that marriage is about compromise, but it made me have a greater realization because obviously Ryan and I have the same morality, we have the same belief system, which is the foundation and it's the most important part of our relationship. But other than that, we are so different. He is a morning person, I'm a night owl. He's super outdoorsy, I'm very artsy. I love videos and filming videos. He hates anything to do with social media or filming anything, and I've tried to convince him to get on a video, and so I'm in the process of convincing him more and more, but all that to say, we take each other outside of our comfort zones. For me, Ryan has pushed me to try out surfing, which is something I wanted to do, but I was afraid of waves. And so we've tried a few times, but it is a process for me. It just made me realize, wow, marriage is really about compromise because we can get into silly discussions, silly little arguments about stupid things because we come from two different backgrounds, from two different point of views, and if we don't seek to understand each other and push each other to grow in God, there will be challenges. And so this is something that we continue to learn as we grow in our relationship and as we seek to learn about each other's differences. God is the one that brought us together, and what God brings together, no man can separate. This new season in my life also made me realize God created marriage to represent Him, whereas Satan came to destroy marriage. And if you think about the divorce rate, it continues to increase because people have this view as if marriage is about them and meeting their wants and needs and desires, and it is not at all. I want to pray harder in this season. Just like I prayed when I was seeking discernment regarding my relationship with Ryan, I want to pray for our marriage, I want to fight for our marriage, because spiritual warfare exists, it is still out there, and Satan came to destroy what God created. And I believe marriage is a beautiful depiction that represents Christ in the church. And so this is something I want to seek after. I want to seek after God's guidance and His wisdom. So I can pray against Satan's schemes to separate Ryan and I. You know, we want to build a strong bond that is founded on Christ, because anything that is founded on Christ can never be broken. I was reading Romans 8:2, and I asked God the other day, can you give me just a verse or a passage that can really speak to my heart right now in this season that I'm in? And Romans 8:2 came to mind, and it says, "And because you belong to Him, the power of the life-giving Spirit has freed you from the power of sin that leads to death." This is such a powerful verse because it reminds us that we have all we need in Christ. When we accept Jesus into our hearts, He comes in and transforms our spirit and gives us wisdom, guidance, and direction. And He speaks to our hearts. He freed us from the wages of sin and death. And I want to make sure that I'm seeking God during this time so that I don't fall into sin, so that I continue to grow closer to God, because each new season brings new challenges. I continue to tell myself, okay, God, what do you want me to learn? What am I struggling with right now? And what do I need to surrender to you? Because ultimately, that is what truly matters in life, living for God, not for ourselves. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching. I have so much fun documenting this series and really showing you how God has been speaking to me and how God wrote our love story. And so I hope you continue to join in on this discussion and this journey with me, because I love making these videos for you guys. So if you have any further questions or video recommendations, leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe for new faith-based content every week. And yeah, I hope you all are having a blessed day, and I will see you very soon for another video. Bye, guys.